friends, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing really well. So today's video is going to be a try on of a new foundation, like first impressions and wear test kind of a video. And today I'm trying out the new Maybelline Dream Cushion foundation. This is a new launch in USA. It retails for around $16. This hasn't launched in India. In India, they have launched the BB Cushion foundation. I know this is not in India, but I still think that Maybelline would probably launch this in the future, so I thought why not try it out. And I've been hearing a lot of good reviews about this foundation, so I was really interested to try this out. I picked mine from Walmart and I have this in the shade True Beige. So I plan to do like a wear test for this video and take you through the day and show you how this wears throughout the day, and probably do like maybe two check-ins for you guys because I have to head out. So I plan to carry my camera and show you guys how this wears. So yes, if you want to know what are my thoughts on this foundation, then please keep on watching. First off, this is how the foundation packaging looks like, very similar to the L'Oreal cushion foundation packaging. So first let me read what they have to say about this foundation. So it says, Maybelline's increased color pigments deliver complete luminous coverage for fresh faced perfection in the Dream Cushion Fresh Face Liquid Foundation. Benefits: it's liquid foundation reinvented, complete luminous coverage for all skin types. And that's pretty much what they have to say about this foundation. So just like any other cushion foundation, it comes with a nice mirror, and it comes with this sponge applicator, which I had never really used because I don't feel it's that convenient to use. And when you open it up, it has this flap right here, which you remove, and here is the product. So the Dream Cushion foundation comes in 8 different shades, which is not really a lot like in comparison to other foundations. Like even the Fit Me foundation comes in so many different shades. So it's not really enough, but it's not bad either. So yes, without wasting much time, I'll just get started with the foundation application and let's see how this performs. So I've just moisturized my face and applied some eye cream, and just like how I do in my other foundation test videos, I don't really use a primer if I'm testing a new foundation, just to see how this wears throughout the day without any primer on the face. So that's why I haven't used any primer, and I'm just going to go ahead and straight away apply the foundation. But before that, I need to correct my under eyes. To apply this foundation, I'm going to use my damp YBP Makeup Perfector sponge. I love this sponge. This is so good. So, see, I just dabbed it once and picked up a lot of product. It has a really nice coverage, guys. Like, it's way better than the L'Oreal cushion foundation in terms of coverage. So this is a close-up of my face with just the first layer of foundation, and I think it looks pretty good. Like, it gives amazing coverage just in that first layer of foundation, and at the moment I don't feel that I have any foundation on my face. It feels so lightweight. So I'm just going to dab my sponge once more into the product and just see how it builds up the coverage. So adding another layer of the product definitely builds up the coverage, at least that's what I personally feel. I'm just going to add some Maybelline Fit Me concealer. So I've already set my concealer with the Fit Me powder, and I'm just going to use a little bit of that powder just all over my face, just to set my face. So I'll quickly complete the rest of my makeup and I'll be right back. So guys, I'm back with my makeup done, and my initial thoughts on this foundation is that I really love the way it looks on my face. Like, it gives an amazing coverage. It feels super lightweight on the skin. Like, even now after layering products over it, I don't really feel that I have anything on my face. Like, every other product that you use over it sits beautifully on the face. Like, you use your blush, your contour, anything, it doesn't look bad or patchy. Again, considering the fact that I didn't use any primer, I think it looks really, really good. It definitely looks very nice and luminous. It's not really like matte. It is a very natural finish foundation. I would say that this would suit all skin types, especially if you are like normal to combination skin. You would definitely love this. If you have like very oily skin, I don't think this would be the best foundation for you, but again, it's not going to be bad for your skin type. You could definitely use this, but you'll have to probably do 2 to 3 touch-ups throughout the day. So I need to head out for some shopping and for some other work, so I plan to take my camera along and do like a check-in for you guys and show how this wears throughout the day. So yes, I'll just make a move now and I'll get back to you guys. I'm heading out for some shopping. I'm going to go to Sephora. The current time is 1:06 p.m. and I wore this foundation like 4 hours back, and I think it looks still pretty good. It's looking really nice and it has not faded, it has not oxidized. I'm so happy with that. So guys, I finally reached the place. Sephora is just right behind me. You see that? You can see that now. It's right behind me. So I'm going to get into the store and pick up some items. And again, I'll give you a check-in before it gets too dark. Guys, I'm done with my Sephora shopping, and I did quite a lot of shopping at Sephora. And I haven't done any touch-ups on my face, even at Sephora. The current time is 3 p.m. and I'm so happy with the foundation. Definitely not happy with my under eye area. It's kind of fading. The concealer is fading. But yes, the foundation has performed really well without any touch-up, which is really good. So guys, the current time is 4:36 p.m. and it's gonna get dark at 5, so I had to do this last check-in now. And I'm super pleased with this foundation. It's amazing. I highly recommend trying it out. I have done no touch-ups whatsoever for it's more than 6 hours now, and it's amazing. So yeah, this foundation is definitely worth trying out. I think you must definitely check it out. And yeah, I'm going to end this video here. I hope y'all found my review helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos, and I'll meet you soon in my next video. Bye bye.